The U.S. Department of Agriculture's National Agricultural Statistics Service recently came out with the latest agriculture census. Our own Teodora Mitov joins us in studio this morning, breaking down some key findings. Teodora, what was the biggest takeaway from the census?
Yeah, the biggest takeaway was the loss of farmland in our state. Between 2017 and 2022, the census outlines that Iowa lost over 500,000 acres of farmland. More specifically, the state lost just under 588,000 acres in total.
The biggest issues with farming is access to land. And when we lose that many acres, that really inhibits accessing land, especially because land prices aren't in line with productive value. The market value far exceeds the productive value of the farm for a year-to-year income.
And Worley said that it's unknown what exactly happened to this land between the 5 years, but the general trend is that farmland around suburban and urban areas is being sold to developers. The main farmers that are impacted by this are new farmers or those who are trying to upscale their businesses. That's because it's difficult to access farmland since it's expensive, and a lot of farmland doesn't go on the public market. So having less total acres available adds to the issue of trying to find acre access, according to Worley. But there are some positive takeaways from the census. An economist with the Iowa Farm Bureau notes that compared to the nation, Iowa had more positive results since we gained farmers and farms. But looking at the present, he said this year may provide some setbacks.
From where we sit right now, 2024 is likely to be a year of tightening the belt for many farm budgets. Still optimistic in the short, medium, and long term, but definitely some headwinds that exist in this year that we weren't experiencing when the census was done in 2022.
But on the bright side, Worley said that while she still expects there to be continued pressure with development and farmland, she says there are ways to turn the tide. And one of these ways is she's seeing a greater interest of farmers growing table food. Now, Iowa crops typically are used for animal feed, processed foods, and ethanol. But this new interest in table food requires a smaller acre base. So that's a bright side there, Justin.
Yeah, definitely good to see some silver linings in this report. Is there anything that people at home, non-farmers, can do to help?
Yeah, the best thing people can do is shop local, and ways to do that will be on WHO13.com.
All right, perfect. Thank you, Teodora, for the update.